Dave Isaac alongside my co-host, Aaron Gottlieb, and friend of the show, Chris Wheeler, joining us our last day in Clearwater. Wheels, we're heading home now. Long road trip for us back there, and the Phils, they couldn't pull it out for us. We're now 0-6. Over the last 2 years, we're 0-6 down here. But a couple of guys that we saw when we were down here, wanted to ask you about Jason Donald. He's seen a lot of action.
Yeah.
And John Mayberry Jr., both of these guys have been hitting the ball really well. What, if any, chance do either of these guys have in making the team?
I think a lot of it depends, Dave, still. You know, as you said, you got to go home, but thankfully we're still staying. It's pretty nice here. You know, you still got a long way to go in the exhibition season. A lot of it depends on Feliz and Utley. You know, if they can stay healthy. Chase is close to coming back. You saw Feliz is playing a little bit right now. They have to decide at the end of spring training, then, or the last week or so, what they need for the bench. You know, both those guys have been very impressive. Jason Donald can play a lot of positions. He's a dirt ball kind of player. I really like watching him. Mayberry gives a little power, maybe at AAA, maybe at the big league level. I don't know whether you have a kid like him around, sit around, you know, and not play. So a lot of it still has to shake out. But one thing about it is, you know, you got two pretty good players, it looks like.
Well, a guy that won't be coming off the bench is Raul Ibanez. And that was probably the biggest departure, or the biggest move. And fans still, you know, upset about Pat leaving, and he'll always be in their hearts, you know, somewhat. But how long will it take? He had an RBI double today. How long is it going to take that layover from, you know, not forgetting Pat, but moving past that and seeing what Raul has to bring to the club?
Well, that'll be up to Ibanez, Aaron. You know, if Raul Ibanez does what he's done in the American League, it'll be fine. You know, and I don't know whether you ever forget about what Pat Burrell did and what he accomplished. And, you know, it's pretty cool for us to see him leading the parade down Broad Street. I mean, because he's our friend. You know, he's a guy I've known since he was a kid, just coming out of college. And I like him so much personally, and yet I understand it's a business thing, and you decide you want to move on. You may have gotten a little bit better athletically. You may not have to run for Ibanez in the seventh inning or defense for him the way that he had to for Pat. They don't think they're going to have to. That's something that Charlie's going to have to figure out as it goes along. He's supposed to be a slight upgrade there. If he were right-handed, it'd be perfect. He's not. He's left-handed. But he's a professional hitter. You've seen him a little bit down here. This guy can really swing the bat. And God, he works so hard. So did Burrell, too. Burrell was a hard worker. This guy really works hard. He's whatever, 35 years old. And boy, what a, you know, he's in great shape and all that. Good guy in the clubhouse. So, yeah, there'll be a hangover. But, you know, if he goes out there and knocks it and runs right away and does what we think he can do, it'll go away.
Well, moving from hitting to a subject I know is your forte, pitching. Kyle Kendrick, now he hasn't looked his best this spring. So who's the front runner now to take that fifth position? And it seems like, you know, I was talking to Aaron about this earlier. We kind of have the same questions for you that we had last year.
Yeah.
Who's the fifth starter going to be? Not Adam Eaton, obviously, this year. But
yeah.
I guess Chan Ho Park seems to be the front runner along with
Jay Happ.
Jay Happ,
well,
right.
I remember my infinite wisdom. I probably told you last year I didn't think we had enough pitching to win the World Series or anything. So, I really didn't. To me, the pitching was remarkable last year. Of course, you know, we talked about Lidge, and we knew if Lidge was Lidge, he's going to be good. 48 out of 48, come on. You know, you're not going to see something like that. Happ's an intriguing guy. I think Happ's more a starter than a bullpen guy. So right now, to me, he might be the guy, although, you know, Chan Ho Park can do either. So it's still going to be, a battle to the end to see who fills that spot. Fifth starter is a guy, a lot of times you don't even use him that much, so you get to May because you have the off days, you have rainouts, things like that. So it's important, but it's not the most important thing you're trying to do. I feel bad for Kyle because he's kind of caught in between. He's trying to work on new pitches, and yet he's trying to get people out, and his best pitch is a sinker, and he's up with it. So, you know, as a result, he's getting hit hard. You saw him get hit hard here the other day against Atlanta. So, you know, a lot of us really like Kyle a lot personally, but, you know, it's a tough business.
As we thank Chris Wheeler for joining us once again on the ADD Show, we leave you as we go back to Philadelphia with the sights and sounds from our trip in Clearwater. Starting off with this Mets fan that we, not going to lie, had to check to make sure he still had a pulse. But we'll see you back in Philadelphia. Thanks for joining us on the ADD Show.